Good afternoon, students, and welcome to the class 7 of mathematics. Today we'll start with the chapter 1, integers. So let's have some introduction. In the previous standard we studied some numbers, that numbers are natural numbers. That set of numbers are natural numbers. So natural numbers are the numbers starting from 1, 2, 3, 4. Next set of number is the whole numbers. So here when 0 is added to this natural set of numbers, this new set of number form is a whole number. Now we are going to study a new set of numbers, that is a integers. Integers is a set of all negative and positive numbers. Now these are the natural numbers. Whole numbers are what? These are positive integers because they don't have a sign in front of them. But if I put a minus sign in front of all these digits, we get the negative numbers. So for example, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, and 1, 2, 3, 4. These all are integers. So next we are going to study is a number line. Now you are quite familiar with the number line. This is a number line and I am showing here some integers on this number line. Now say this is a 0 and there are some numbers to the right hand side and to the left hand side of this 0. So the numbers to the right hand side of the 0 are positive integers, while the numbers to the left hand side of the 0, they are a negative integers. So when we go to the right hand side, the value of that number goes on increase, and when you go to the left hand side of a 0, the value of that number goes on decrease. And remember, 0 is neither positive nor negative. So next topic which we are going to study is how to find the sum on using this number line. So first take an example, 6 plus 3. Now this is a number line. I find here 6 and took 3 jumps to the right hand side of the number line. I got the answer as a 9. So on a number line, when we add a positive integers, we have to move to the right hand side. So minus 6 plus 3, 3 jumps to the right hand side, we get minus 3. Now what if I add 2 negative integers? Remember, when we add 2 negative integers, we have to move to the left hand side. So minus 6 took 3 jumps to the left hand side, we got the answer as a minus 9. Now next, how to find out the subtraction on a number line? For example, 5 minus 3. So find out the position of 5. And while doing a subtraction of 2 positive integers, we have to move to the left of the number line. So 3 jumps to the left of 5, we got the answer as a 2. Same here, 5 minus 6. So 5 and 6 jumps to the left hand side of the 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Answer is a minus 1. So 5 minus 6 is a 1. Now what if I add subtract 2 negative integers? So minus 5 minus minus 3. So let's do here minus 5, and remember now we are subtracting a 2 negative integers, so we have to move to the right hand side. So this is a minus 5 and we have to subtract minus 3 from that, so move to the right hand side. So here 1, 2, 3, we got the answer as a minus 2. So answer is a minus 2. Next, what we learn, you should remember while doing addition and subtraction of integers some points given below. What are that? When two positive integers are added, we get a positive integer only. For example, if I add two positive integers, 56 plus 73, my answer is a 129. And what if I add two negative integers? When we add two negative integers, my answer is a negative integer. So minus 56 plus minus 73, answer is a minus 129. Now, when we add one positive and one negative integers, first what we have to do? First we have to find out the difference from bigger to the smaller, and the answer will get the sign of a bigger number. So here 56 minus 56 plus 73. Now first find out the difference, 73 minus 56, it is a 17. Now who is bigger? 73, and it is a positive, so your answer is a positive. Now next, minus 113 plus 82. So first find out the difference, 113 minus 82, what it is? It is a 31. And with the negative sign, because 113 bigger. 113 is a bigger integer, bigger number. So, next topic we are going to study is a additive inverse. Now, additive inverse is actually the opposite of a given number. So, if your integer is a, its opposite is minus a. If your integer is minus a, its opposite is a. So, let's have an example. The additive inverse of 8 is minus 8, while the additive inverse of minus 8 is 8. Same here, additive inverse of 13 is minus 13. What is additive inverse of minus 45? It is a 45. Now, next topic is comparing and ordering the integers. I am again revising. When you go to the right hand side, value of that number goes on increase, and when you go to the right hand side, value of that number or integer goes on decrease. So while finding the answers, you have to imagine this number line. So let's have some examples. This is minus 7 and minus 10. It's minus 7 and 10. So who is to the right hand side of number line? 10. So 10 is a bigger. Now in case of 29 and minus 63, who is to the right hand side? Imagine the number line. Of course, 29 is on the right hand side. So who is bigger? 29 is bigger. Now what in case of minus 8 and minus 18? Imagine the number line. Minus 8 is on your right hand side, while minus 18 is on your left hand side. And always number to the right hand side is a bigger. So minus 8 is a bigger. So let us recapitulate what we studied. What is integer? What is integer? Integers are a set of whole numbers and their opposite. That is a set of all positive and negative numbers. Then we use how to use. Then we studied how to use a number line for addition and subtraction. We studied how to. What is additive inverse? Remember, additive inverse is the opposite of the given number. And how to compare and order integers. Thank you for watching video.